Hello everyone and welcome to New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host, Richard Evans. Make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. Today I want to show you how to use the grab and record function on your TriCaster using the control panel. Now this is a very simple but very important function of your TriCaster which can be controlled easily with a control panel. So let's dive in and show you how it's done, son! Alright, so I'm going to start off in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and I have a very simple show today with just four inputs coming in, and I'm not going to be doing any switching on this one today because I'm just going to be going over the grab and record functions on the TriCaster interface first before we move over to the control panel. Alright, so before we get that far, let's go ahead and set up the output configuration of our TriCaster so that we can tell our system what we want to record and what we want to take still image grabs from. Alright, so to do that, we'll click on the gear icon in the bottom right corner of our program output window, and that will bring up our output configuration. So the first tab that we want to set up is my output tab. So I have mix number one is currently set up to be my program. Mix 2 is input 3, mix 3 is input 4, and mix 4 is input 5. And I can select anything going on in here. All right, so now let's move over to the record tab. And now this is basically going to give me an option to record all of these different mixes that I have signed up here. All right, so let's just put a checkbox next to 1, 2, 3, and 4. All right, so that will take care of the video and audio recording side of things, but now let's go ahead and take a look at the grab side of things, and I can put a checkbox next to those as well. Now, I'm just utilizing the mix function within the TriCaster. Now, you can go through and record the grabs and the video and audio from individual inputs by clicking on the gear icon at the bottom right of that input source, and then going to record here and then also grab and setting it up that way as well. But I'm going to keep this simple and just use what I'm working with on my program output because that will make things easier for this example. Okay, so in order for me to do a record, all I have to do is go to the top of the screen here and I'll hit record. It's going and I'm now recording all four channels that I've selected here, my mix 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then I can stop that simply by clicking on it, and that'll turn it off. So then you can throw them into your DDRs or export them, however you want to manage your show. All right, now when I did that, I want to mention, I'm going to click on this gear icon here. So this doesn't really give you any options except for doing replays, which is going to be covered in another video on the YouTube site, youtube.com/newtaking, so check that out. I do want to mention, let's move over to the grab side of things, since these buttons are right next to each other. The grab option is what's going to allow you to just grab still images from the different mixes that you have assigned to it in that output configuration. Now, what's cool about this is if I click on this gear icon here, I can say I can throw my grabs directly into my DDR1 or into DDR2, graphics 1, graphics 2, or I can select all of them if I wanted to. But I'm going to say let's put them into DDR1 and graphics 2. So those are going to be here at the bottom of the screen. And now whenever I take a grab, they will show up there. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to hit grab and bloop, there you go. Check it out. So now I have mix 1, 2, 3, and 4 over here. And also over here because that's how I assigned it. All right, so let's get rid of that. That was just for an example. Now let's move over to the control panel. Ta-da! Y'all seen this before. This is the two-stripe control panel. And let's go ahead and focus on a specific part of the control panel, which is up here. All right, so to do the grab and record options on the control panel without having to do it on the interface side of things, you're going to be looking at 8 and 9 here on our numpad, and I also wanted to mention this as I did in the last tutorial video. If I have numlock selected, this isn't going to do anything. All right, so we need to make sure that numlock is off, and now I have access to both my grab and record options. All right, so this is pretty simple again, but let me just show you here. I'm going to take a grab here by pressing 8 and bam, I've done that, and then you'll see on the interface that I have done my grab there, and I have all of my stills that have been populated into my DDR1 and graphics 2 like I had set it up before. All right, so now let's go ahead and start the recording on our TriCaster, and pretty simple, just press record here, And you'll notice on the interface now I am recording up there at the top. Now, one thing I do want to mention, let me zoom my camera back here and show you this. So I'm recording, and if I was wanting to stop my recording on my interface, well, I just grab my mouse, hover over record, and click that button again, and it'll turn it off. Now, on the control panel, check this out. If I click record here to try to turn it off, nothing is happening. That way you don't accidentally stop your recording when you're just on the control panel side of things. Now, when I did that, also keep an eye on this button here at the bottom of the screen. The shift button is now lighting up. So this is kind of similar to how the recording operation on the three-play systems work, is if you try to hit stopping on recording while you're still recording, it's not going to do that because you need to do one other step to stop recording, and that is to hold down shift and then press record. And that will stop your recording. That way you don't accidentally hit that button and mess up your recordings during the middle of your show. So again, very simple things to go over here on this particular tutorial, but it's nice to have it all within your fingertips so that you can just click it right here. You don't have to go back over and mess with the interface. You can just hit your grabs and your records right from here, making your show super easy. So again, very simple steps to grab stills and start and stop recordings on your show, but also one of the most vital parts of your show as well. Now, I hope this video was helpful, and if you'd like to learn more, click subscribe on the NewTek YouTube page at youtube.com/NewTekInc. And if you're looking for more detailed training on NewTek products, check out NewTek University at newtek.com/newtek-u. And for more information on NewTek products and services, you can contact your local reseller or visit our website, newtek.com. And also, if you're sharing your work on social media, tag us using the hashtags NewTek or TriCaster. I love seeing what y'all are working on. Thank you again so much for watching, and I'll see you next time for another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. Bye.